Oh, fuck.
Oh, look at those
anime
kill a kill. Kill a kill.
He's slicing the rain around you into an open dome. It seemed as if they derived some sort of twisted pleasure from this brotherly fighting.
I remember this was the start of, like, Devil May Cry trailers having reveal, you know? And I was like, what?
This is also just we're beefing because fuck it, right?
Yes? It's one of the weirdest things where their original rivalry is actually really poorly defined.
Oh, tuck it up! Tuck it up! Yeah, nigga! Tuck it up! It's rain!
The water holds it together. When you turn around and pick up your sword, get stung! The fucking 180 stinger on it.
Oh, wow. He doesn't even have a coat on.
Sorry, not open for business yet.
And his face is all melty like a teenager.
Yeah.
This joint, and I'm already getting calls.
Oh, yeah. Come to think of it, back in DMC3, when he's starting the place up, he's getting calls all the time.
You
in one, it's
too?
Like, eh. And now in five, it's like, oh, I'm broke.
Yeah.
If you want to use the bathroom, help yourself.
I mean, it's, you know, like, as we get older, we lose spunk. Is so going back in time for maximum spunk is the best fucking plan.
Where did you hear that?
From your brother. He sent this invitation.
What a obviously evil man.
Accepted.
So the cutscenes here were directed by the, I want to say, action director for Versus.
Versus, exactly.
Yuji Shimomura.
Yep.
Which went on to get shit tons of work with everybody in the character action scene.
Including Twin Snakes.
No, that was Rihei
Kitamura.
Yeah, it was the director.
Yeah! Reaching mouth for that pizza.
And, so the cutscene director for this also does Bayonetta, which will become very obvious. So here's your tone setter, right?
Or, I was like, oh yeah, is our protagonist dead?
And it was really weird because I remember the first interview talking about this cutscene when it came out.
Yeah.
Was two things. One, they wanted you to be able to do everything in a cutscene in game.
This party's getting crazy.
Right.
Let's rock.
This party's getting crazy. There's the line.
Yeah. But also, like, Dante's level of durability in cutscenes is exaggerated in. Compared to regular gameplay.
Well, this is the introduction of cutscene Dante.
Yes.
This is what you should be aspiring to be, right?
But cutscene Dante can take all the hits in the world and still keep his style up.
I mean, here's the other thing, too. This establishes as well the fact, well, not even, it's like, when you see Dante get impaled in the first game, it's not even remotely a big deal.
Yeah, he's like,
it is the most nothing, because he's been impaled three times since we hit the start button.
So that is a move you can do in the game, which is kind of bad, but you can do it in the cutscene, so you can do it. But now watch on the upper left part of the screen where the sword comes from. Wait for it. Oh, it did! Oh, thanks, sword! Thanks, Rebellion!
Self-assist.
Don't bet on it.
Oh, boy.
Put it on.
Look at this.
Look at this unnecessary coat. See that? No drugs, no alcohol. Just pizza.
Yeah.
And coats.
And goofy moments. Oh no!
My sneeze destroyed my shop.
I can't believe it. Now check the billboard in the upper left.
To cover all this.
Yeah.
There it is! Holy shit, a big tower is coming up out of the ground, I can't believe it!
This fucking tower has always just been Temenegru.
Temenegru.
Like what? I don't know what that's a reference to.
It's random devil shit. Shut up.
It's such a weird, specific Japanese sounding name, I guess.
What's good?
Is actually
I come well. Doesn't it excite you?
He's getting off in his pantaloons at all this demon shit.
Temenegru.
The Great One, who once ruled this earth as the medium between the human world and the demon world.
Like, if you're talking cool about my pappy, I'll tolerate your bullshit.
It's a magnificent view.
It is a pretty nice view. It's high. It's tall.
In their time, those who revered evil constructed
the idea of revering the concept of evil.
Now. After two millenniums of
confusion. It's one of those, because Jesus was Sparta.
Right.
Which was intended.
That's none of my concern.
This voice actor's name is Daniel Southward? Is that his name?
He's taking
He does
care.
A great job!
Yeah, he sounds super, nerdy, but it's great.
It is the only memento left from the mother you both lost.
But he has no idea of its true power.
There's a nasally quality to every line.
Oh shit, it's the boss I just fought and barely beat. Look, it's the same boss.
Daniel Southworth.
Southworth.
That is none of my concern.
Oh my god, our rival character just beat the boss that I had trouble beating and went, oh my god.
Right.
It's the simplest.
And it's also, it's like, okay, Dante, cowboy, guns, swinging around, Wild West.
Yeah.
Brother, blue,
Asia.
Japanese sword, Asia. Yeah, exactly. He would ride a horse if Dante was riding a
horse. Hey, best girl.
Oh yeah, absolutely.
Hey, let's all check out the burning enemies in this next shot, shall we?
I thought you were gonna say let's check out her age in this story.
Oh, what's gonna happen? Oh, they made a three! Oh my god! So I'm not that great with the gunslinger on that, but with the Coyote A, also known as a shotgun. Oh what? What? I just hit L2 and just...
Oh my god!
So, let's do a little bit of a test. So here's your shotgun. It has now lost the bug from DMC1 that allows it to just shoot like
ba-bang,
crazy.
Ba-bang, ba-bang.
It has now gained this instead.
So who fucking cares?
It also has fireworks.
Fireworks, baby!
Which is why,
Let's swing our shotgun like nunchucks.
And just shoot it. It also... Oh, I don't have it yet. Okay, you also later gain stinger, but with the shotgun.
Gun stinger. We don't recommend using your shotgun like a nunchuck in real life.
Never.
Yeah, there you go.
Oh, what a dumb fucking piece of shit.
So, anyone, take a quick guess. What do you think this
what's
is
this
called?
What's this character's what name? What is the character's name?
What could it possibly be?
You have about a minute or two before the boss title shows up.
Tridoggo.
No, oh, you're ruining it.
Hellwoofer.
Hellwoofer's pretty good.
So you have forbidden in this land. You are powerless, but not worthy to set foot here.
Oh, he's chained up. How sad.
I've never seen a talking mutt before. You know, in a dog show, you definitely take first place.
So the characters in DMC 1 were annoyed at Dante's shenanigans.
Yeah.
But here it's like, ha ha ha, jokes. And then every single one goes, Ryan, fuck, Dante! It's like...
But also, it's because it's a human.
Yeah.
So why the fuck, you know what I mean? Would a human not be shitting their pants in their demon presence? Yeah! Yeah!
Unfortunately, all of you that guessed Ice Bud were wrong. This is Cerberus.
Who knows? I'm not even sure myself.
That's bullshit, you absolutely
know. Your strength. I acknowledge your ability. Take my soul and go forth. You have my blessing.
Oh! Thanks!
Right? demons are like, yeah, all right, you're cool.
We'll hang out.
You're okay, get in. They have no problem just becoming a weapon. And fucking...
It's cool, bro. I love to be a weapon and hit demons. Very kind compared to Bayonetta's demons.
I'd say so.
Which have to be forcibly turned into monstars.
Well, and that's probably because they're angels.
Yeah, you're right. You know what? Demons are polite.
Angels are dicks.
Are mean.
Angels are dicks. I've seen this before.
Oh my god.
Troublesome dame on a motorcycle.
Get out of here, Resident Evil movies.
No guy. Oh fuck. God, jeez. Why would you? Blind fire the RPG. Yeah, that's back!
This is the height of cutscene Dante right here.
And it's back! You can do it in-game, baby!
In POG form.
He loved it.
What if Dante was just a regular person and had just died?
I mean, Snake can do it. Fighting Liquid?
Shut up. No, he can't.
That's he did it.
That's
fanfiction.
That's fucking awful fanfiction.
You know who's a regular person?
Lady.
Lady.
This just keeps getting better and better.
He's just like, I don't know what that was. But
I don't know who that was,
but all right.
Looks like we have an uninvited guest.
Is that so?
A human. A woman.
So now with the proper reveal of V, we can point out that V and Arkham share a shit ton of similarities.
Walking around with a fucking book.
That yeah. Is what you want. Imagine if V's gameplay is...
Actually, I happen to be acquainted
actually,
with that woman.
The other thing.
Oh, God.
Oh, that'd be great.
I would enjoy that. It's approaching.
Can you feel it?
Moving texture face.
You gotta get that fixed, bro. Ugh.
Yeah, it's,
ugh.
Some bad acne. Yeah, teen breakouts, it happens.
That is not acne, that is...
You go to, you know, you come. Everyone comes back after summer in grade 8. Some people have fucking Arkham face going on, you know? It's not their fault.
Oh. Alright, so we have now reached the primary location of the main game, which is Temenegru, which is a big evil tower.
Don't say it smooth to make it cool, it's Temenegru.
So the main thing about Temenegru that bums me out is that it's just not as cool as the castle in the first one. It's like...
But it's kind of like Tartarus.
It is totally like Tartarus, and it does have, like, this cool angel statue is fucking awesome.
It's a rad one.
That's rad. And I can see that it has some design elements from, like, Mundus's final area, because it's nice looking.
Also, you can ride a motorcycle down the side of it.
But it's just not as interesting. You're gonna hear a very bizarre statement from here, from my mouth just now, so get ready. The best way that I found with the style meter in these games is to look at style as, like, an efficiency meter. You min-max your style.
Fuck off.
You have to min-max.
Fuck off. You're not gonna ruin this for me.
I can ruin anything for anyone, sir.
You're not going to.
Don't you tell me what I'm not gonna ruin.
Just announced for 5 is the ability to watch the pre-viz cutscenes live action.
So the way that shit is phrased makes it
great.
Sound like there are just live action cutscenes in Demon.
That's what I thought, but
no
it's pre-viz.
To use yeah. Violence, devil boy. Oh, wait. Better listen to what others say, lad. This tower.
Do you guys remember
is
Joker?
I do.
You see?
In fact, I remember that his name is Jester.
Excuse me. We'll do no anyway. I fucking
I love this guy.
I'm not a fan. I'm not a fan.
That could be a problem. Just hear me out. You've got nothing to lose, right?
I like the way he moves around you.
Jester.
He's supposed to be as annoying as he is, so I get it. I get it.
That's why I love him.
I just fucking hate everything about him. I just really don't enjoy
him. You like him. You really like him.
I really, really don't enjoy his existence.
You love him. What are you talking about? He's looking out great. It's a fun time. I'm not being sarcastic either. I really like Justin.
I really don't like him. I don't even remember his fucking name.
Get to the point. Or you want to keep Bond dancing. Look at him go.
Actually, I prefer a sword to be my partner. May I have this dance, m'lady?
Like, I like the way he moves around in the cutscene.
Yeah. That is
what the something is.
That's a fun way Remember to do it, kid? But god damn.
Write it down on your hand if you don't trust your head.
Also, here's a weird shot of him firing the gun like it's a machine gun. Like, he is pulling the trigger, but the fucking firing rate is so consistent.
You still piss me off, though.
I think Dante and I feel the same way as we cut away on his abs.
In the rain. You're the one who did it. You are the one who did it.
What's wrong with topless brothers fighting in the rain?
Don't worry about it.
On top of a Metal Gear.
The curse of old games that you think you know better than you do. Yes, yeah, this way.
It's kind of like when you recommend someone watch a show and you forget about the middle episodes that don't have a lot going on.
You forget about Poopy Pants. Remember him? Remember when he started shitting all over himself? You're like, oh, I remember when it was he did that cool fight against the bone dude.
Yeah, I mean, there's a whole lot of random shit that happens in Gundam before the...
Boy, there fucking is!
Before the good shit happens.
Buy the toys, losers.
You know, it happens. What you gonna what?
Well, you get your sleepies in there.
Hey, man. I have not closed eyes since the last time we recorded.
This is exactly the same as the DMC1 thing. Remember? You hit a trident into a thing.
Then you do your thing. Yeah, true.
There's a precedent set.
Yeah, we recorded the end of one.
Then Wooly went home.
And then played Nier.
And then Wooly then got the animation for these episodes.
And then I made the intro for the or did animated the episode for the intro for this, and then I did the had to chop up the Nier and edit and shit, and everything was fucking all night, and then straight up. Walk back to the fucking office and pop this in and start playing this. So, hey, it's fine. There could be, there are worse games to fucking LP on no sleep.
Hell yeah, there are.
You know what I mean? Like, God. Fucking am I gonna, what? But.
You know, Pat, I really don't feel like playing Devil May Cry 3 today. Fuck that! Who would ever say that?
The spirit is willing, the body is weak.
Fuck this game!
No! I'm saying...
If I let
out a yawn, it's not because it's an emotional yawn.
No, it is. Don't lie. We all know how bored you are with Devil May Cry 3.
Yeah, every time Virgil's not on screen, I'm
You're just like, ugh. You're just like, take off your shirt, loser.
What the fuck?
Which is funny, because in this game, Dante kind of already is at the take off the shirt level.
He starts there.
So they wanted to give him a different look, so they made his coat more pronounced. How'd they do that? By taking his shirt off.
Yeah. Young Spunk. What he's all about.
And a lot of people have issue with his bra. Or I mean his gun strap, but I don't know. I think it looks cool.
Hey man, West Coast.
I feel like it's actually there to cover his nipples, so you're not just staring at his nipples.
If the leather strap bra is good enough for Tupac, it's good enough for Dante. That's what I say.
Is that what you say?
That's exactly what I say.
I don't know how I feel about V. By the way, this is being recorded in September of 2018.
The announcements for DMC5 with the trailer and the reveal of Dante's music was yesterday.
That was yesterday.
So that whole saga.
The timing is
impeccable.
Perfect.
That entire saga.
We could not have timed it better. We did not.
Dude, so like, if I went home and fucking popped that theme in, took a listen. I looked around the room to make sure what was happening. And then I immediately went to Little V Mill's Twitter And the first thing I saw was, yes, I heard it, and I'll see what I can do. What a fucking hero.
I'm gonna do my best, guys, but I don't know.
What a champion.
This is a tough one.
You're right. We have to be gracious hosts.
You sure do, guys.
You guys talk a lot.
How do I know? We need to come up with something. Brother, our guest is...
Sighing.
Sigh.
What is sigh?
I love these guys.
Sigh is when...
Enough already! How long are you two gonna keep carrying on like this? In case you didn't get the hint, I'll spell it out. Your guest wants to go through. Got it?
I love these guys.
Agni and fucking Rudra.
These two are the best.
They're the best!
Because they're the swords.
They themselves are wielding their own heads. It's fucking great. What a super cool design for a demon.
Yeah! Yeah! Yeah!
Yeah! Nice.
Wait! Yes, wait!
No transformation necessary.
Because they're weapons, they're just weapons.
A very long time for someone stronger than us. Someone who can control us. My name is Agni, and my name is Rudra. You shall take us with you. We can be a great help to you.
Okay, but on one condition.
What is it? Name it!
No talking.
Oh no, but I love them!
Fair enough. As you wish.
Yeah, I'm gonna stick to Swordmaster on camera and just level up Trickster off. Because you need Trickster at certain levels to get certain blue orbs. You need the dash.
And now we get a fucking kata to show you what you're messing
Look,
with.
Look, I'm so cool!
Show you what you're messing with.
No talking.
I'm gonna require.
Good.
Oh, wow, they really did not have, like, a higher res version of this.
Well, what are they gonna do? Re-render them?
Yes!
They've not that much effort for the trilogy. She's pretty alright.
She's the best.
For a human.
The human's greatest equalizer of all, the firearm. How many firearms does she need? A lot. She has many, many firearms.
Her guns are stronger than Dante's.
Much.
It's almost like Nell Goldstein made them weak on purpose.
What? Get out of here with this new lore, alternatively old lore from the novel.
Oh, I was about to say, what the fuck are you talking about?
That are pseudo-canon.
Nell was there before.
Oh my god, what did she do?
But it's like, you can tell when it's mocap, right? Like, you can see it. Who's this crazy lady? What's her name?
That one's a little easy to get.
Yeah.
That's a 6.
Basically Makoto with weapons.
Basically. So yeah, there's 2 delays. You get that. Or...
Yep.
Oh, it's the best. It's the best.
What?
Shut the fuck
up! It's because you're throwing them down so hard...
That they're getting into it.
That either that or they're just... Oh, it's gone!
No, I think they're getting super hype at your crazy sick style moves. And they're just getting in, and he's like, I said no talking, shut the fuck up.
You've grown stronger.
Sure have.
Go to hell.
You point a gun at me? Your own kin?
Your dear papa?
Oh my god!
The only thing I ever had was my mother. And she's dead!
You break my heart! After all, it was I who gave
Look
you
this
your name.
G.I. Joe.
I know, right?
My darling daughter.
No.
Ow, bullets. Right. Right.
Didn't dodge that. Well, that's that problem taken care of. Hey, terminal velocity. What's that? Fuck.
Oh, my legs flew apart.
This is right? Kind of rain. You dislocated your fucking hip.
I look so funny today.
Let me go.
Let you go? But it would be a waste if you ended up as just a pretty stain.
Ow!
Yeah, he didn't think she was that nutty. Turns out she was fine.
And once again, what if he was just a normal guy?
I'm trying to help you. And you show your thanks by shooting me? Whatever. Do as you please.
So he's a demon too.
I'm beginning to think I've got rotten luck with women.
Yeah, a little bit, buddy.
Here's the thought process.
Oh, it's a seven!
Here's the thought process. She didn't know he was a demon, so she just shot some guy in the head.
She just shot some guy.
Fucking lady.
Why would she? God damn it, lady.
Just some guy just tried to help, and you just went, fuck you, bang!
You're a jerk, and I don't like you.
And then she does it again.
Oh, we're in the pitch black void. So this is where Arkham was at, doing his Arkham stuff. Being evil. That kind of thing.
It's the acne.
Yeah. It's not acne, it's like a rash. Do you even know what a pimple looks like?
Like Arkham?
There we go. Oh!
What's that? What's that teen juice that the kids take to get rid of all their
virility?
The fucking gross face. What's that thing called?
The teen juice.
That, whatever that cream is that they advertise to be like.
Oh, I don't fucking know.
Get rid of all your acne. Take this teen juice. There's a thing. They had commercials for it, and everyone's like, "Oh man, I took the juice, and then my pizza face went away."
I genuinely.
You never seen it?
I couldn't. I'm so huge, fucking confused. Your fucking use of the term teen juice.
There's a huge market for it.
Well, yeah, having pizza face sucks shit. I should know, I used to have it.
There's also a market for blorbs that you can't reach.
Talk to me. Oh!
You know, there's that the stage-to-stage sort of awkwardness, like you said, of like someone being like, I'm just gonna wait or whatever, and to get this parry. Bosses are the perfect parry bait.
Yeah.
Because you're fucking just one-on-one-ing them. You're learning their pattern anyway. So bosses feel really, really good. And some bosses feel even better than others.
Yes, obviously.
If you're picking up what I'm putting down.
Put your fucking dick away.
I will not. You shouldn't have popped this game in.
There's not even an end to that sentence. Oh.
You shouldn't have. You popped in the wrong game if you didn't want to see my dick. You know better.
Put that on a fucking shirt, man. Fucking.
You know better. Hey, look, it's your final boss.
Yep, right here. Right at the beginning of the game. Remember this part from the intro.
The trimmings.
You showed up.
The trimmings, y'all. Remember when we used to play tag?
No food, no drinks, and the only babe just left. My sincerest apology, brother. I was so eager to see you, I couldn't concentrate on preparations for the bash.
It would have been a sick rager, I promise.
At any rate, it's been a whole year since we last met. How about a kiss from your little brother? Or better yet, how about a kiss from this?
So they're twins, but I guess Virgil came out first.
Virgil totally came out first.
So, this is what they call a heartwarming family reunion, eh?
Back when your neck wasn't so fucked up.
Like, that's his stinger. Yep.
Cross-up slash.
He's got a Royal Guard equivalent.
Slash SS.
fuck. I couldn't jump after that one. And he's got that. And that is the end. Oh! God damn it! Get that secret mission now, goddamn bitches.
Yeah! Now I'm motivated!
Fuck. This is why guns don't work against Virgil.
Get the fuck out of here with that shit! Throw that back!
I'm glad they just all lined up so perfectly so Dante could do that.
Why do you refuse to gain power? The power of our father, Sparta.
Father? I don't have a father. I just don't like you, that's all.
That line makes no sense. Makes zero sense.
You know what his beef is, right?
What?
Mother.
Hey, Mommy. He's gonna love me like you better.
So I know you don't like it, but this to me is definitive.
Yeah, look at their shirts off.
Controls everything, and might can troll everything.
Yeah, well then, if he's so good, how come he's dead?
Here's all his win quotes.
Yeah,
these in a row, right? Literally all three. Give me that shit.
Can I have it?
No. Give me that shit. Fuck off, boy.
Oh, but I want it.
This is non-DT, basic ass swordsmanship battle cannon.
Yeah.
Gun sword versus sword,
and. Depending on difficulty, summons.
Virgil fucking takes it. Straight up.
Ow!
Give me that shit.
Ow, that hurt, bro.
Ground stinger.
Yeah, it's a stinger!
like, because Nello Angelo has the moveset that you've got. Yes. He can do it. He just doesn't want to.
Or he doesn't remember or whatever.
Like, no, I think Virgil's style meet trick style whatchamacallit.
Dark Slayer.
His menu is all of Dante's styles minus Gunslinger, but they're just an X on them. Because he's like, nah. In the same way that Dante can grab the Yamato and do Virgil shit with it if he wanted.
So here's the thing. I always interpreted that is that because Virgil's DT had awakened earlier, that he was just physically more capable in this first fight.
Oh, you think
because that's what happens here.
Yeah, you think that's what
Dante's
it is.
Able to punch through the sword, and that's why in the second round they're completely equal.
Okay, so you think he's got the head start on him?
He has a massive head start in a lot of ways. Cool. He clearly gives way more of a shit about all of this and the sword shenanigans.
Yeah, but...
Oh, what a weird punk man. That's weird.
Dante put his points into style.
Yeah, thanks, Kazuma Kaneko, I think?
Yeah.
For guest starring from the SMT series to make a Dante.
Big Bug Man.
A cool look that will be thrown away quite rapidly. Because yeah. It is a guest look.
So that's what happens. That's what puberty is really about, guys.
It's, yeah. Awakening in that devil inside. Fighting shirtless brother in the rain.
Why do you refuse to gain puberty?
Oh.
why do you hold back when you can embrace the hair in strange places, Dante?
No thanks. B could have been worse. Save that game.
B is for brother. I've unlocked easy mode for you.
I just remember this cutscene having the dumbest move ever.
But yeah, it's the fucking.
Just get shut up.
this is what I was referring to. It's like, oh no, the vibration on the ground. Okay. Yeah, the fucking blood goyle shish kebab.
This is it. Here it is.
The most insane thing
Shoot
ever.
Shoot the sword.
Because that's how physics works, y'all.
He's outrunning the sword.
At terminal velocity, no less.
Oh, he's running so fast.
He's got re-entry flames on his run. Yeah, it's kind of insane.
Yeah. And if you look closely in the background, you can see a big old 8 on the moon.
Yeah.
At some point.
What is Dante even doing there, you know? But it's like, yeah.
It feels like he wants to get eaten by the fish.
Where was he going to go if that demon wasn't there?
To die.
Hey, pro tip to all the parents of twins out there. Unfulfilled. If you split a magical amulet that you own and give it each half to each kid, they're probably going to end up fighting over it.
Yeah, probably.
Even if you want it to be some cool double dragon shit.
Especially if you color coordinate them
oppositely. Right? What's double wrong? Dragon had the same idea going on, and even they fought. They're probably going to fight.
If you have two kids and one is red and one is blue, start worrying.
And if, especially if the strongest wins the second half, and that gives them the ultimate. Yeah. Maybe don't do that.
Maybe don't. Oh, he landed next to the tower where it was safe, where everyone had already been killed. Don't worry about it. Gross, dude. You would probably actually be covered in way more blood than that, I would think. And your clothes would be completely ruined.
Eh. He still angst it a little bit.
So this is the next stage.
Wait!
If you're asking for a date, forget it. Because I make it a point not to go out with women who shoot me in the head.
Date a demon?
What, you go out with women who shock you with electricity and stab you with your own sword instead?
I really don't care for guys Mother. Stink like
it doesn't, you know what? I've been thinking about it. It's never even implied any romantic connection of Dante with anyone.
No.
Ever.
You're right.
Not really. Because again, you can just say it's just motherly. Right?
Motherly affection.
You can leave it off there,
She nurses me. It's not about sex.
But don't tell me that, like... Yeah, so I feel like, don't tell me that the future implications, right, of Dante hanging out with Lady and Trish is not that they got some kind of fun three-way party going.
No, it's not.
Because it feels like it is.
It's way lamer than that.
It feels like it's Dante and his ladies.
Yeah, 9.
Who counted on that anyway?
That was a weird cut.
It is.
That felt wrong.
Just like
that,
the last cut.
That felt... Oh, man.
Yeah, you disagree with Dante and his ladies?
I do disagree with that.
Okay.
Because they show zero interest in Dante.
No, but they just show up together.
Yeah.
Is why. It feels like, you know, the action figure would come with them behind.
It's like Dante's a better fighter, but the other two seem better at actually living the rest of their entire lives.
Well, they're part of, yes, but they're all part of the Devil May Cry team. And then in 5, Nero and fucking Nico joined the core.
And Kyrie maybe? It's not clear.
Making dinner up in the kitchen when your arm gets ripped off. Oh boy.
Thanks, honey. I appreciate it.
Maybe she was so unimpressed with Nero, and then and she heard about that new arm
Nico made this
in advance, and then she was like, "Maybe we should let this random stranger in to pull that fucking arm off."
Maybe. Oh, that's dark. Oh, that's so sad to do.
Maybe the Devil Bringer is not fun in the bedroom.
I assume that's actually the implication. Because, needs more power. Like, no. You're not Tim Allen-ing my pussy here. Fucking calm down.
Just snatch a whole new meter.
What is it snatching?
Something painful.
Oh!
A bad idea. Stop it, Nero. Stop spending proud souls.
Stop. Get... I actually saw a really decent explanation on the different types of cool that Nero and Dante are.
Oh, come on.
Yes. No, they are very much two different types of cool.
Okay.
Dante is surfer California cool.
Yeah.
And Nero is punk.
Oh, that's true.
Because look, and it was describing the way that they taunt enemies.
Yeah.
Dante taunts enemies for him.
Yeah,
he taunts them to have fun.
Yeah.
Nero, especially later in his life, he has a couple that are like, are you scared or like whatever, but
Nero,
it's like
Nero aggros.
It's mostly like, ooh, getting crazy in here, right?
Nero's
like, fuck you, bitch.
You can't attack.
Like,
sick of your bullshit.
Dante is actually, ironically, a lot closer.
Good shit.
A lot closer to Nero than he ever was Dante.
So if Dante's taunts are surfer and Nero's punk, then does that make Virgil prep school?
Yeah. Makes Virgil a prep, and it makes V a goth.
Yeah, I guess so. I guess so.
Like, think about it.
What are goth taunts like? What?
You know what it is?
These taunts are just gonna be like, wow, you're a bigger loser than I am.
No, you know what they are? you know what they are? They're fucking William Blake quotes. And then the phrase, so it is written.
So it shall be done.
Yeah. You familiar with that, by the way?
I'm not.
In the trailer, he who desires but act not breeds pestilence. It's a William Blake quote. It's an old literature quote.
So he's just gonna quote shit at you?
Yeah, he's quoting fucking, nerd shit at you.
Okay.
Like a big dumbass.
You're too deep. These lyrics are too deep for you. You wouldn't
understand. They're way too
them.
Deep for these stupid demons. Restore the mask and the power to part oceans. You'll gain that Moses shit.
I hate the bands you like.
That's his devil trigger. I hate the bands you like.
All the demons get super mad.
Hey, baby.
What up, Shoddy?
Hey, girl!
See Dante's face? He's like, ooh. Hey,
oh,
ooh.
Hey, girl!
Ooh, he's already getting excited. Shoutouts to not PS2
Welcome,
hair.
Sir.
Here. You're not my mom.
You'll be nice to me, won't you?
Of course I will. I'll treat you so nicely. You'll never want to leave.
Now that's what I'm talking about.
That's so awkward, Dante.
Yeah.
<That's> so weird.
Hey, sexy lady. Can't wait to get you back to my place and turn you into a guitar!
Yeah!
Dante's concept of cool is so weird! It's so
turning a sexy girl
into
girl.
A guitar so I can shred all night, baby! Literally shred all night.
I would like to shred you. What are you saying?
Nevin Nevin's like, I was going to have sex. I thought
we were going to do a sex now.
I was here for the copulation. I thought that would have been a good time.
What? No. Ew, get that away. I just want to play this tasty lick.
Oh, fuck. Oh, you're just doing Jack Black as Dante right now.
Check this riff. It's fucking tasty.
And everybody else is just like, Jesus, Dante, fucking...
Can we just...
Jeez, you're so fucking awkward.
You're so weird. Why are you so weird, Dante?
Why has it gotta be like this every day with you? Every fucking day, it's weird. Okay.
That's great. I feel like, I've seen that a couple times before, right? Like, No More Heroes, girl with command grab that embraces you and fucking sucks your health and...
Get away from me, bitch. This is not for you. This is for mom. We have to stop.
I wish I could turn mother into a guitar. Mother would be an acoustic guitar.
Because she's old.
I would strum her.
Okay, come on now.
I was like, doesn't she have one other...
Gotcha! Oh, there we go.
My, you're sweet.
So she's one of them Irish sex ghosts, like the one that attacked Beverly Crusher in Star Trek Season 8. Remember? No, not Season 8. Sorry. 6? 7?
A succubus?
No, she's closer to a Dargul or a Lina Enchide.
But you're no slouch yourself.
That's why she got the red hair.
You knew my daddy?
Because she's from Ireland. Okay, I'm gonna die into a guitar now. Sparta used to strum me before your mom.
Cool, sexy lady.
You fucking
loser. Oh, now he's playing subhuman. Close your ears, everyone.
Look at this fucking loser.
He's even playing it like a fucking asshole.
You know what? You know, this is what it is. This is what Dante thinks adults do behind closed doors.
Yeah, he thinks this is what cool people are.
When you go on a date and then at the end of the night, everything's going great. You go to her room and then you all just play guitar. That's what adults do.
That's not what it's about, man.
Oh, man.
Oh, boy. And I did it.
And this was before Trish.
Much before.
Oh, God.
He's like, Trish, I learned some tricks playing guitar.
The fact
that- Oh, I forgot how cool this was!
Yeah, and this is where you, like, Lady is the basically, like, the template for, oh, human beings can be that good in this world.
I'm using the power of the human being, the gun.
Like, that level of insanity? Okay. No wonder demons can catch bullets out of the air with their swords and line them up.
Yeah. Because this is the top shelf of what, like, a 17-year-old can pull off. If you just give them enough guns. Hey, I'll live with a bee.
Ads.
Daps.
Yeah.
Maybe we can get it by the end of the game. Daps.
Sads.
So stupid.
Soon we will reach the.
Oh, hey, now they're in the
judgment.
Cool part of the fucking tower. Where the architecture is wildly different for some reason.
Lead us into the demon world. The world where Sparta's power has been.
You see that fucking video of, like, Dante's like, to get my half of the amulet, you gotta defeat me. And Virgil's like, just doing this dumb little shuffle dance with a sword in his hand.
Yeah, I have seen this. Pulls it out halfway. This morning. It's super good.
Sword.
I love the incredibly obvious distinction at this point that.
Does that woman really
Virgil's an asshole, and Arkham's like proper
about?
Evil?
Mm-hmm. Why didn't you kill her? Perhaps because she's your daughter.
Oh, snap.
Did some pesky fatherly love get in your way?
That's none of your...
To further your study of the black arts, you sacrificed your loving wife. To become a devil as well. Knowing this, I thought you'd be more useful to me. But I was wrong. No wonder your attainment of power is incomplete.
You're pretty one-track-minded, what about you, Virgil?
For good reasons.
You're an incomplete being as well.
10.
Both demon and human blood mingle in your veins.
Shut up.
Do you see that response as kind of bratty, almost?
It's definitely, yeah. You know, he doesn't want to hear the call out.
Now that the final door is open, I have no use.
See, because it's all on, the thing is besides his fucking nasally cold-infested sinuses, which Southworth can never do again unless he gets sick.
Yeah.
Was he sick during this?
He had a cold.
Oh, are you serious?
So every time he re-records the lines, it's never quite the same.
That's legit.
That nasal
fantastic.
Quality is because he actually had
a cold. I fucking love what
he
you're saying to
cold.
Me right now so much.
Foolish this, that pay. Foolish. Foolishness.
All right.
That man. Did you kill him?
I clearly just arrived.
I did. Woo!
Equilibrium.
Unfair equilibrium.
I love a fast woman.
Shut up! He was obsessed with becoming the devil. So much he killed his own wife.
No!
Forget he butchered innocent people.
Oh my god! I forgot what a fucking kind of dickhead he said in the scene.
That's the right response. That's the...
Yeah, Dante.
He murdered innocent people.
Your coat takes a massive beating throughout the game. Once again, another mechanic that we'll see later, as you can do everything in the game as you can do in the cutscenes. Hey, look at that 11 on the floor. Do you see it?
Seen it.
You can see it early here.
We have something in common. I have a dysfunctional family too.
And what would you know about family? You're a demon. This is my father. My family. This was all supposed to end by my hand.
Ooh! Yahoo!
Fucking dub Mario noises over, like, the fill your Dark Soul with light.
Aren't you gonna shoot? Well, that's a switch.
Just go. I don't care anymore.
Family, huh?
Like, you get the feeling that Dante's been coasting through life as a nigh invincible super god. And just really never grew. Like, how old is he? Like, 20 here? 16 to 20?
17 tops.
Right? But, like, he's so immature even for that age.
Because he grew up watching TV.
And it took, like, a girl who stabbed him, shot him in the face to be, like, freaking out and trying to murder him over her dead dad to go, huh. Family, huh?
Like, Dante watched a bunch of fucking the Fonz and Zorro.
Where am I?
And then figured out his personality based
it's
on
dark.
That.
I can't see anything.
Fonzo? Look at that good ass secret mission. I love DMC3's version where it's always some weird fucking thing.
This is DMC3.
Ah, whatever. Shut up.
Oh, you poor thing. Didn't your mother ever teach you how to use a door?
No.
I knew it.
Huh? Give me a break. Tell you what, next time I'll try and wear some cologne, okay?
It's the stench of betrayal, the odor of that accursed Sparta. I will annihilate every last population of Sparta!
Son cleaning up his dad's mess, huh? Where have I heard this story before?
Yeah! So this guy's just straight up like, yo, your
He's
father-
He's a brawler!
Your father fucking pissed me off. Come catch these hands, son.
Fuck!
Right through. Like- Oh, fucking ate it.
You know what I love about this fight? You lose it. Like, in my mind, that's a loss. Right? Yeah, you blinded him and he leaves, but if you were a human being and not a devil, you would have just died.
Father. Come on, man. Cut me some slack.
Well, to be fair, all of this would have been a
yeah,
loss.
Yeah, you're right.
Like, come on, lady.
You're right.
Lady is not fucking beating off these dudes.
What?
Lady is not beating off, like... Oh, God.
Not these ones.
Prime demons? No. Lady's taking on the chumps.
Yeah, she's beating those ones off. Is that it?
If Dante weren't here to do
and
the
then,
job
and then
for
Dante
her.
And Dante and Virgil are over there shirtless in the rain.
Dante is here to do the job for her in advance so that she can come along and clean up. I gotta use the bathroom.
Yeah, I know.
You excited?
This party's getting crazy.
Even the devil boy is no match for it.
Oh, look, it's Jester. He's fun.
Hey, look, it's Joker.
You're not going to shoot me, are you? If you do, I'll die. You know?
If that's what it takes to shut you up.
What's up with your heterochromia?
What's up with the fact that even your Jester cap has heterochromia?
Well, you know.
But Willy,
Margot Robbie.
That's not Joker. Joker lives in Arkham.
But
that's Jester.
But Harley Quinn loves Joker.
Thought I was a goner.
Look,
sure.
Look at the blue and the red.
I see it.
On the Joker and on the Jester hat.
You saw it.
Get it?
I get it.
Tower jutting out of the ground. That thick shaft that causes.
Can't wait for that new Jester movie starring Joaquin Phoenix.
Linking the demonic domain to the human.
Is that the prequel with Jared Leto?
Your brother Vangel is the one who controls it by.
He's a normal guy, no hair, and then he turns into this thing.
He's headed to the control.
You're just going farther.
I'm trying to get to Jester with Disturbed tattooed on his forehead.
No, he's too fun for that.
No, wait, damaged, excuse me.
He's fun. And let's just get a good... Oh, look, there's the Cerberus one, which is really cool. It looks like Virgil's. Like the head, I mean.
It does. Yeah, absolutely.
You know why, I bet? Because it's blue. Ah! You get it? This is Virgil's blue... Oh.
I don't get it.
Doing jokes over here.
I don't get it.
Alpian, it's a hard life. No, it's not. But it's a hard job. No, it's not. Doing my best over here, gang.
Hey, no, actually, you're right. I'm just fucking up timelines.
Don't worry about it. The story doesn't matter. We keep saying that, but I actually love the story in two. Sorry, in three. In three. I'm so sorry. I feel in my heart, though I could be wrong, that there is totally a smidgen of what's his name? Griffin's theme in here. Just like the smallest piece. Damn it.
You might be crazy.
It's possible.
I'm gonna say you're crazy.
Yeah. I've heard such things.
Don't act like you don't know.
There's a trailer shot for you.
How could we have known that it was actually a style that we'd never really use?
Oh!
Tokiwo Tomare.
So here's the real question. How did Dante forget about this? It's so busted.
In fact, it's so busted that he decided to not use it anymore.
It's no fun.
This room is really cool.
It sure is. Almost like you'll have a cool fight here. No, that's clearly a different person.
Right?
And here's where it's like, well, even if Virgil and Dante are now literally the same level of, like, power, this is to still show off, like, nah, Virgil's still rocking it.
I hope no one ever calls me Seed. Not great.
You know what you just did, right?
You know you got fucked up, right? So you know you done fucked up.
I hope no one pastes my head on a bunch of bullshit garden equipment. or the Seed of Chucky poster.
Time to test out these moves on your corpse.
Ah, that's the
bomb! Ooh.
Now that we've gone back in time, one of the amulets is gold for no reason. Shut up.
Even a bow and arrow.
Yeah, totally. Hey, it's that bell again that I pointed out. And now for the most over-the-top cut-your-hand shot ever.
It hurts.
No, not that one. This next cut. Oh, you mean where you sliced off all your fucking fingers for some?
So unnecessary. Local man getting very motivated. So if someone came up to you and was like, it's you, Seed of Boyvin. Like,
I'd be like, yeah.
Wouldn't that feel kind of gross?
I don't know. Depends how you feel about your extended family. Or direct family.
Well, the active word here being Seed, not Boyvin. Boyvin. I don't want to be Seed of anything. Son of Sparta? Cool.
You gotta come from somewhere, man.
Seed of Sparta.
Birds and bees and shit.
It's like... Damn, like, I kind of became a person in between.
Oh, you did.
Well... It's you, Nut of Sparta.
You know it!
Oh, shit.
All about that demon nut! Jump!
No.
Dude, it's
no.
Crazy.
You are locked.
Let's see if I can do better this time than I did the last time. Two of the best cutscenes in the entire game, too.
Let's fucking go!
Is there something missing? Must more blood be shed?
You seem to be in a bad mood.
Dante.
So, my mother's amulet is the key that unlocks the door to the demon world.
13.
There it is.
Good plan, Pop.
Just
early, again.
Originally, it was the key to the demon world, but was given to humans as a gift.
It doesn't matter to me one way or the other. More importantly, I've come all this way.
Even the music gets the build-up.
This, by the way, this is the track.
This is the track.
Time for one more game.
That
not the last track.
No, this is
not the first track.
This is the track that always shows up when Virgil shows up in any game that he's in.
After all, we share the same blood.
It's also the track that will be in DMC V if you get the collectors, whatever.
Virgil 2. 3 is great.
3 is great.
1 is great. Virgil fucking 2.
It's so good.
Come and get it if you can.
Come and get it.
Yeah! Ah, this compression.
And also,
this unfortunate
this fight
compression.
Is cutscene going better as well.
Sorry, but this is no place for a little girl.
Like, seriously, so get the fuck out!
Shut up!
Get the fuck out!
Back in the kitchen. I will shoot you with my gun if you say that again.
Can't you see some cool shit's happening?
We're having a moment! What are you doing? We're about to take our shirts off!
Foolish girl.
What?
Getting in the way of a good pairing.
And now we finish the cutscene even.
Slice, slice.
Bravo!
So what we did not see in that was
smoothly.
Summon swords.
Well done,
no, you don't see that was until later difficulties.
You.
But
they're there.
They're there. They're sure. They're there. Super there.
The mocap for these scenes is nuts, by the way.
Or you can expect
like, you go on Ruben Langdon's YouTube page, you can fucking check out like all the goofy shit they had to do to get the slides.
Oh, yeah, like we're just pulling on ropes and shit.
Zowie, that
the samurai
was
catch.
But you've taken quite a trouncing today, haven't you, Virgil? You could have chopped me into confetti by now if you were in tip-top condition. Damn you.
So the slide you're about to see.
You have lost.
That one. So what they do is they actually knock the guy down and then two guys jumped in to hold his legs.
Feet, and then they drag him on his feet.
No, just to held him in place. To hold him for the recording. All sorts of goofy shit.
Wow.
And they used wires for all of lady stuff.
You bastard!
It's time for your spanking, my dear.
I really like Arkham slash Jester's, like, just appearing next to you in scenes gimmick.
Virgil, you have
father's blood. You had everything you needed to unleash the evil.
I told you before.
What a bizarre way to say that.
A bigger mouth than mine.
Evil.
You are wounded and weak.
So here's another reason to hate Jester. He's getting in the way of some cool shit.
And he stomps everybody.
To you.
Haha, you guys played 13 missions of a video game. I didn't.
A set of Sparta's blood. Now, I need one more key.
The stupid family getting in the way of some cool family shit.
But it's a different family shit.
No one cares about this dumb family.
No, she, they care.
His own devil's blood and a mortal priestess. I needed you.
I don't know how she shrugs that off for the rest of the game.
As the sacrificed woman.
Well, the fact that he picked her leg as opposed to her body.
Yeah, but it's like right through.
Yeah.
But it's still like, oh, look.
It was quite a ride.
He could have killed her there, but he didn't.
If any of you had died before getting here,
I fucking love his little dance. And here it is. Yeah, I love it. It's so, his animation is so good.
To make you battle each other in order to weaken you. But at the same time,
yeah, a lot of games with cutscenes had, like, the mocap stands the fuck out.
Oh, yeah.
Because,
this is one of the first ones that were just like,
clearly.
No, we're gonna just mocap the shit out of this. And then tweak it after for style. Mary,
Metal Gear as well.
Your dear mother.
It's time for the clown to bow out.
Oh, he's got the lines,
dude,
too!
The show's over.
And they're cool.
I'm still cool,
impressive.
Right? Don't forget about me.
I expected nothing less from the devil's descendants. But aren't you forgetting something, Virgil? The spell is broken. What do you think will happen next? Let's welcome chaos.
Oh, that's cool.
Ooh, big sweeps.
Oh, it's so good! Oh, man, it's so good!
If he was playable, that would be a move. Wait.
He is! In the new game! Nah, he won't be doing kicks like that because of his cripple leg. But,
no.
But it's as close as you're ever going to get. Every archetype that has ever appeared in this series will be playable in some form at some point.
But, like, sweep into collect the body and kick it over there. So that's a fucking good move.
Oh, we
and
gotta,
he keeps his hands up.
We gotta get that guy. He's bad. Whoa. What a bad guy.
He got in the way of our moment.
What a bad guy.
We were having a moment. D-sads.
Is that the same one I got before?
Sad. Sad for dad.
No. No. Oh, gotta start up this next mission.
I thought this may be fun.
Oh my god, the whole layout was perfect. Oh my god.
You put a tower in your tower so you can tame any group while you're below.
Man, you didn't think that through. While you're timing to go out of I am having so much fun playing this fucking game again.
Yes, I'm going to finish him off.
Oh, she puts a little thing on her leg. That's
well
how.
Get it, because you're no match for him. Regardless, I must go. I had a chance to stop him before, but I couldn't. I'm responsible for all this mess.
You fucked up.
Responsible.
You fucked up.
Does it bother you that much? He's my father. Besides, who else can undo what he's done?
I absolutely love the morphology of Dante here, slowly learning to
a demon like you
give a shit about literally anything.
Sure.
To in five, he looks really tired. He's just like, ah, demons. You know the old Simpsons joke of Star Trek 40?
Yeah.
Oh, the Klingons again. Like, Dante's like, oh, yeah, it's Demon King.
Well, he's also not used to the weight of the world on his shoulders at this
hurry
point.
If you don't want me to take all the credit.
Yeah.
Did you see that, like MS Paint comic thing of, like, just Virgil being like, no, Dante, this is not a crazy party. This is...
I am trying to kill you with my samurai sword!
We are fighting for our father's legacy.
How did Dante... No!
No!
Not Wahoo!
I fucking love that version! Oh, shit, that's great!
So, I shit you not, when I was watching the DMC5 footage with Dante using Cavalier, which is his motorcycle weapon, some of these moves are in the moveset.
As they would. You see that comparison of the shrouded figure with the mark, with the covered face? Yes. And the top lip?
Yes.
Resembling Olivia?
Olivia? Who?
Not Olivia. What am I saying? DMC2 girl. What's her name?
Lucia.
Lucia.
Dude, that'd be the craziest thing ever.
That would be the best. That would be such a cool way to save it.
Fix that.
Fix it. Yeah, here we go. This is peak fucking ridiculous Dante.
Blew up Lady's motorcycle. Why would you have done that?
But he's like, that was kind of fun though. I should probably think about that in the future. That gives me an idea.
So yeah, I like the idea that with Dante, it's mother. Right? But with Virgil's like, Daddy's so strong, I want to be just like Dad.
Dad, you protected everyone.
Dad, you were so strong. You told me my controls everything. I'm going to be stronger than ever.
I need more power.
Oh, fucking turning protagonist's motivations into fucking baby drivel is just the best.
The moment he said the fucking mother. Oh! Dude, you know what I completely fucking forgot about because it's been years and someone recently brought up too. In Ultimate, right? When you can pick Virgil versus Trish.
Right. Oh.
And they have talking intros.
Sure they do.
Can you imagine what he says to her?
Mother?
He just goes, how disgusting.
Oh, great.
Yeah, so he's super disgusted by her entire existence and wants her fucking dead, which is awesome. And when she wins, she's like, oh, you're nowhere near as fun as your brother.
And it's like...
How disappointing. And it's like, ew!
Ew.
My mom shouldn't be saying that I'm not fun! That's fucking gross!
And then Dante...
Trish, do you not understand how gross your existence
and then
is?
And then Dante's there in the back smirking, going, Mom, you think I'm more fun than you, Virgil? Yeah, oh, I'm the favorite. No!
Okay, well...
Oh, I got it.
I think you went in. I think you just fought everything and then
I never went into this room. I will bet you $10 right now that I didn't go into this room. Fuck.
Just air trick.
I don't have it. I have Swordmaster. It's what I need. I love you, Swordmaster.
No, you don't.
Swordmaster's my mom.
It's getting me killed. Fuck, this is awful.
Don't worry about it.
He plucks the threads that make us dance finger and toe. We surrender in joy to the lowest of the foul and rank. We submerge through
darkness.
Hey, look,
it's all those statues.
I love them. Filth.
Hour by hour, we move downward, ever closer to hell.
Man, he's having a lot of fun with his little
poem. He is masturbating prose right now.
Let the world resonate.
Like you can't see the tent he's pitching.
Gluttony. Greed. Envy. Lust. Wrath.
Full Metal Alchemist.
A bell of chaos that tolls human desires.
Turns out they were bells.
Oh my goodness. Is Sparta Jesus in this analogy?
Yes. But he's demon Jesus.
Got it.
Destruction. The idea of a demon sacrificing itself to save humanity is the exact opposite of everything we know.
Yeah.
Entrap this world in fear as its very
of anyone who tries to pronounce it properly.
Oh man, look at that. Look at all them bats. They're the easiest enemies to jam into this scene.
Because they're just JPEGs. You can see that there's three real ones.
Yeah. Sure, buddy.
He's getting in there.
He sure is.
Hey, what you up to, girl?
Being tired, probably.
What's wrong? You tired? Then stand back. I'll take care of this.
No, you stand back.
Ow!
I told you, you can't do it. Don't you get it? This is not a human's job.
You're the one who doesn't get it. It's not something you can reason
with. Our last interaction was kind of okay.
It has nothing to do with me being a human and you being a demon. I'm driven by the inability to forgive him. My soul is screaming, demanding me to kill him.
She's psychoanalyzing herself.
Yeah.
That's enough motivation to keep me going. Besides, this is my family matter. You should stay out of it.
Okay, lady. I get the picture, but I can't just sit back and watch either. I'm pretty pissed at him too, you know.
Here's your baby
now,
gun.
Get out of my way, or there'll be some consequences.
Fair enough. I wasn't planning on letting any demons live anyway.
Oh, shit!
Yahoo! Sorry, lady.
Points for determination.
I'll take care of him.
You would think this be romantic, but it's not.
Why do you care so much?
Hell no.
Because she's not his mom. This whole business started with my father, sealing the entrance between the two worlds. And now, my brother's trying to break that spell and turn everything into Demonville. This is my family.
Well, clever, Dante.
Quite frankly, at first, I didn't give a damn. But because of you, I know what's important now.
So Lady is the real savior of the Devil May Cry series, if you really think about it.
Because she reminded Dante about family.
Family.
Trust me, I'll make things right for you. That's what my soul is telling me to do.
Use this.
Here's the problem.
How much is it gonna cost
me? You can give me your name.
Dante.
Here's the most amazing weapon. I have given you my ability to survive this castle.
Yes. Luckily, there are no demons in this room, so she can just hang out here.
Yeah. But the chess pieces were there.
Please. Free my father.
But it's kind of nutty to think. It's like, here you go, the thing that's been keeping me alive.
Well, she has her other gun.
She does, and she did use them.
But that's the peacemaker.
That's
right,
the problem solver, you know, like. Meh. And she came with enough ammo, I guess.
She came with a nonsensical amount of ammo.
Ammo?
What is ammo? Now we beat each other up and we're friends. Oh look, hell's purple.
How interesting.
I like that purple, it's good purple.
If I had to make a jacket, maybe I'd make it purple.
I went, oh, of course! Yeah,
what the fuck else would it be?
Of course, it's just Force Edge.
The most normal looking sword of the set.
But it was Sparta's.
Because it's locked away.
And they
and that's pretty ornate for a normal.
Yeah, they trimmed the. They improved the design a little bit.
Yeah. But by comparison to the other shit, it's like. Yeah. Yeah, that is a nice reveal.
Look at him. He's like, yay! So happy.
Purple. multiple energy. Your shoe texture is terrible, bro.
Don't worry about it.
Let's wrap up this crazy party, shall we?
Yahoo! Like, he's trying to sound serious.
18. I like that that portal looks like the portal from DMC1.
Oh, okay.
It's great. Mm. Great little detail.
And
this is some hotness. Yeah, I like this.
This is your game's ending. Let's switch those assets up.
Let's reverse it.
Put your thing down, flip it, reverse it.
Why would hell look so nice?
Exactly. Also, here's your DMC Devil May Cry.
Yeah. Oh yeah, you're super right.
Gotta go through the website.
You look at Arkham and you're like, I wish I could skip this fucker with Netflix.
Skip intro. But look at him using Force Edge though. He's doing Force Edge.
He's not even doing anything fancy.
He doesn't know what he's doing with it. Look at me.
Ha 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 ha.
Like, yeah.
So this is the part that was like, oh shit.
Ruh-roh.
That's just Sparta.
Can anyone do that?
No.
Look at that Sentai fucking ranger.
And that's what Sparta looked like, I guess.
Big old bugman.
Big old bugman.
But he's a cool bugman.
Everyone assumes that he actually just looked like a regular person.
D-sads.
Well, I'm gonna love D-sads.
Hey, it could have been dads. Sads for dads.
Yeah, that'd be appropriate. I like that Virgil's actually way behind you. But I guess that makes sense considering he's just sauntering.
The Temenegru is a complicated place.
Hey Arkham, what up? Could be cooler, honestly.
It's like staring into a backed up toilet.
Meh.
Why do you always stick your nose in other families' business? Come on, dude. Don't you have any hobbies?
No, the fact that anyone can just kind of pseudo become you using a little bit of your power.
This is one of my favorite bits where Arkham's laughing and then Dante's laughing also starts laughing. Yeah. And it's like,
yeah.
It's stupid.
Arkham's trying to do the big evil thing, and Dante's like, I'm not having any of that shit.
Again, one of my most confusing traits of I will become an all-powerful flesh monster.
Mm-hmm. Even though the form you were in a second ago was way cooler.
I was so disappointed.
And would have been way stronger, and probably would have been a better fight. But it would have taken away from other things. Yeah, that was a huge disappointment.
But then, they undisappoint you.
But then think about it, though. Wouldn't it be a garbage if, like, I guess you're not fighting the real thing?
Yeah.
You know? So then you have this fake version to compare.
But also, it's like, that would have too much overlap with other stuff.
Yeah. Exactly. Like I said, it would take away from what the game wants to do.
So yeah, he is actually overflowing with the devil's power. He is very strong.
But it just looks like a cell. Like a nucleus, you know? With a little, like, coating on it. You're like, man, why'd you have to go Resident Evil goop monster? Why couldn't you just...
Why'd you gotta turn into these goop monsters?
Like, is this really power than being Sparta? More powerful.
It's the same problem Matt and I have with all the Resident Evil villains who go, I'm now all powerful. It's like you're a fucking whale now.
You're
whale monster.
You're fucking awful.
What's your life gonna be like now, asshole?
You're gonna rule the world as a giant poop monster?
Hell yeah, I am. But I've defeated tons of real demons.
You literally watched it happen over the course of the last whatever this takes place in.
Aw, yeah! Shit, son!
I've come to retrieve my power. You can't handle it. Look at you, making a big dramatic entrance and stealing my spotlight. What? You don't possibly believe that he...
I love the call out.
It's like, oh yeah, right, yeah. Why would this be the final mission? Yeah, that's right.
You're right.
Yeah, actually. Totally. For real. No, well, no
it's,
doubt.
It's not even remotely a problem.
You cannot control the power of Sparta. You're wasting your time, buddy. I think he needs to learn the hard way.
Fucker, I got it first. No, me.
No, I'm going to do it for mommy. Oh, we both got him. Yeah, perfect.
Stinger wrap it slash at the same time. Just fucking X cut it.
Ow. Ow, that hurts a lot.
Trade swords, idiots. All the way through. It really makes me think they just improvise with weapons.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
They don't know what the fuck, but they're like,
it's all natural elite talent.
We don't think about it. It just happens.
It's always disappointing in that shot. I always felt like the cut looked really bad. Like, the X cut just looked kind of lame.
Doesn't matter. They make up for that shit.
Yeah.
Switch.
I prefer my big sword.
Casual switch. Oh.
I'll try it your way for once. Remember what we used to say?
Jackpot.
You know, I noticed that I keep going like, oh yeah, this is one of my favorite parts, you know, right?
Mm-hmm.
But, legit, my favorite characterization of Virgil is upcoming when he is pointing towards your amulet. It is my favorite fucking line he's ever had.
I'm just imagining them running around playing tag, and then someone gets it and they're like, oh, jackpot!
Why does beating him up physically kick him out?
To make him look like a loser.
It's so funny.
So that she can finish him off.
Like hand delivered with a little bow.
With his ass showing.
Why? How could I? I shall become a god. No one here could stop me.
Yeah, everyone can stop you, dude.
What a surprise. Here I was looking for you, and lo and behold, you come to me.
Mary.
Why even have a family, dude?
Don't ever call me that again. My mother was the only one who could say my name.
Wait. Please.
Maybe your brother.
Maybe your younger brother. I got him, driver.
I hope it's not.
I'm pointing at the fucking WrestleMania sign.
Even heroic Sparta sacrificed a woman so that he could become a legend.
That's not.
No, that's why you did it to you. That's why you had a family.
That's not exactly why Sparta did it. Human being
for that reason. I fell in love to have a sacrifice.
I don't think love was a component.
unfinished business to take care of.
Your guts are hanging out.
Yeah.
Mary died a long time ago. My name.
Which she embraces
yeah.
the dismissive thing that Dante calls her.
Goodbye, father.
No! Just make sure. Really make sure.
Triple tap. Quadruple tap.
There'd be six there if she didn't run out of bullets.
Style switch to Kalina and not Kalina and to like the Uzis. Grenades. I killed an old man!
Yeah, I did it!
He was dying!
I killed him! Here comes Dante riding a surfboard with a guitar.
Yahoo!
Get it! Oh,
my force edge!
Mine!
Give that to me.
Here comes my favorite line!
No way. You got your own. Well, I want yours too.
Just, it's so childish!
What you gonna do with all that junk?
No matter how hard you try,
inside that trunk.
You're never gonna be like father. You're wasting time!
Father.
Mother.
Within each of us.
I saw somebody going like, yeah, it's funny and all, but I don't get why they keep making fun of Dante and his mother. It's just because Trish looks like his.
Yeah, that's why! Did you watch the first LP?
Because he looks.
My soul is saying it wants to
stop. Oh, Dante, you're terrible. That line was awful. That's why he's laughing.
He's laughing. He's literally laughing at what a dork. Oh, shit!
Yeah!
Let's do this! Here it is.
Dante.
It's fast! Now that is the baby version of that fight for babies.
Oh yes.
Is that all you got?
DMD is what I, in my headcanon, is what he actually is like, and it is absurd.
Summon swords. Judgment cuts.
Judgment cuts
like,
forever. Huge, huge damage. Big
helm splitter, helm splitter, helm splitter, helm splitter, helm splitter, helm splitter, helm splitter.
The world is closing,
yeah.
Dante.
Yeah.
Because the amulets have been separated. Let's finish this first. I have to stop you. Even if that means killing you.
Oh no. I love that Force Edge without the amulets is just some sword.
It's just a fucking sword, man.
Like, it's a good one, but it's nothing
man.
Special.
Which means any hunk of wood.
With the amulet, nah.
Well, with demon energy, can become some good shit.
So what's really interesting...
I mean, Yamato, we didn't know until later that Yamato has a purpose as well.
Yeah.
And right. And the pull point that the ability that Virgil has to make this game even happen
yeah.
is based on him having the sword that connects the demon world to the human world
mm-hmm.
and keeps the separation.
Like, so you ever watch Screwtech's death battles?
Every once in a while.
So they pointed out Dante's healing speed
it's
based
mine.
On Virgil getting that cut there,
it belongs
and they point out that Virgil
Sparta.
Is healing so fast. That even though Dante's sword cleaves him in two,
he heals it back.
The front of his chest has healed over before the sword has come out his back.
Yeah.
It's these dudes are ridiculous.
You didn't win?
No, it's my amulet. I'll see you in a sequel. Fuck you.
I'ma lose everything, become a stupid mind puppet, but you didn't win.
You didn't win. I'm gonna become a generic enemy later.
Draw game.
You're like, what? No!
Time over.
Dante, can you put on a shirt? All right, fine. It's gonna be tough to get clients without a shirt. All right. Doesn't the bra chafe his nipples?
Can you get a little more serious? Meh.
I guess.
Good job. We saved the city.
What an ordeal. You're still here.
I need that back.
No late charges, I hope.
I'll think about it.
I'd like to think Serious Dante is just like thinking of his dad whenever he's being serious, and he's like he wants to crack a joke, but then he's like, we oh no, wait, I gotta now. Be more serious now.
Yeah.
But I'm and sure then he like it squeaks out like goes, flog off Featherface! Oh no, serious.
Oh jeez. And then fun Dante's like, mother.
There you go.
I hope mother thinks I'm a cool clown.
Are you crying?
It's only the rain.
Terrible day for rain. I said,
shut up. Shut your fucking mouth. I don't want to hear that. I don't want to hear that.
I see. Maybe somewhere out there, even a devil may cry when he loses a lover.
Congrats on somehow fitting the awkward title of this game into a real sentence.
It was way less gross than it should have been.
That could be bad. Because Devils Never Cry is bad when it's implemented.
Alright, you know the number.
I do.
Looks like we're gonna be busy for a while.
So for a second chance.
Well, bring it on. I love this. This is what I live for.
Yeah, pretty much.
Yeah, pretty. You don't spend any money on clothes or like food.
The judgment.
I'm absolutely crazy about it.
Yay, trailer song makes it into the credits. It's like a movie.
So what's actually absurd is like, oh yeah, I have the clean hand as well.
My soul's demise. None of the victims quiet.
It's like, yeah, you could do it stylishly, or you could guarantee yourself to get the number.
Yeah, fine.
It's how righteous for. Stepping forth, the cure's in me. Nothing's here as far as the eye can see.
Oh, man.
What happened next? Nothing, really. We took care of all the remaining devils and...
There he is.
There's the costume I use for the whole rest of the game every time I play it.
Which is to eliminate every last demon. I need to ensure that monsters like my father never come about again. And he promised to help me hunt down the demons, even though he's part one himself. But now I realize that there are humans as evil as any devil, as well as kind and compassionate demons in this universe. At least I've found one so-called devil.
There's that picture of her on the wall, or in the corner.
Cares about. That's enough for me to believe in him.
Now I can start my business.
In this shitty godhead bar.
Speaking of a kind devil, he finally decided on a name for his shop. It took him quite a while to pick one. Want to know the name? Devil May Cry.
What a weird store.
Yeah, that name doesn't last.
Yeah, it turns to Devil Does Never Cry, and then it turns back to Devil May Cry. He's like, it's Trish, it was an emotional thing, but it's stupid.
It's dumb.
Let's go back to the other one. So this is what you get.
This is your secret cutscene.
The stupid three dots.
And I love that he has the DMC1 music cue.
Fight with the Prince of Darkness. If my father did it, I should be able to do it too.
Besides, I already got that chick Super Preggers.
Oh yeah, the Seed of Spartan goes on.
She's Super Pregs. I don't care about nothing.
Well, that's DMC3. I guess we're all done now. Oh boy.
More like that download's done.
Yeah, oh boy.